In this video, patients, families, and donors will learn about the step-by-step donor process for white blood cell donation. Patients needing a white blood cell transfusion are usually facing a possible life-threatening infection that could delay or stop their cancer treatment. Because of the urgency, the donor screening process will start right away once a potential donor has been identified. It is best for the patient and their family to identify as many potential donors as possible, because many donors do not pass the screening. Privacy and confidentiality are maintained at all times. MD Anderson will not share patient information with donors and will not share donor information with patients. There are three steps that donors must complete in the donation process. All of the steps must take place at MD Anderson's Blood Donor Center in Houston, Texas. Step one is the platelet pre-screening and qualification appointment. Donors can register online for an appointment at www.mdanderson.org/bloodbank, or donors can call 713-792-7777 to set up the appointment. Blood donor center locations and hours are listed on the MD Anderson Blood Bank webpage. There are medication restrictions that apply solely to the screening appointment. It is important that donors do not take any ibuprofen, aspirin-containing products, herbal products, or drink any type of energy drinks 48 hours before this appointment. Donors must bring a valid photo ID, such as a driver's license or passport. At this appointment, we will ask questions about medical history, such as autoimmune diseases, perform a quick physical exam, and draw blood to check the donor's hemoglobin level. We will also screen for infectious diseases that are transmitted by blood. If the donor is female, we will do a pregnancy screening test. We will check the donor's veins in their arms to make sure they are suitable for donation. Next, we will collect platelets using a procedure called apheresis. Blood is drawn and passed through a sterile blood separator machine. While the blood is in the separator, the platelets are carefully removed and the rest of the donor's blood is returned back to the donor. This donation takes about 2 hours. We do this procedure with platelets to make sure donors can do the apheresis procedure for white blood cell donation without problems. A professional from our transfusion services team will contact donors typically within 72 hours to let them know if they have been accepted or declined as a white blood cell donor. If a potential donor is accepted, a scheduling coordinator will then work with the patient's team to schedule the pre-donation visit and the appointment for your white blood cell donation. Only donors who have successfully completed the trial on the apheresis machine are approved to move to the next step of taking pre-medications. Step two involves follow-up screening and donor pre-medication teaching and pickup. Once a person is approved to donate white blood cells, he or she will come to the Blood Donor Center at the Holly Hall location for two back-to-back appointments. The first appointment will be the afternoon before donation. This visit will take about 30 minutes. We will draw blood to check blood counts, screen for infectious diseases again, and if the donor is female, we will repeat the pregnancy screening test. If a donor's hemoglobin or platelet count is below the normal range, the donor will be deferred. If it's above the required level, the donor will proceed to medication education. We will teach the donor about the pre-medications. There are two medicines. One is given as a shot, called filgrastim. It raises the white blood cell count. The second medicine is taken by mouth, called dexamethasone. This medicine enhances or increases the number of cells collected. If the donor has a history of diabetes or increased eye pressure, he or she may not be able to take the dexamethasone. A donor's inability to take dexamethasone will not prevent them from being a white blood cell donor. The donor will take these medicines at a time set by the team the night before donation. There are possible side effects associated with these medicines. The most common side effect for filgrastim is that it may cause an aching sensation. Dexamethasone may cause a donor to feel jittery or have difficulty falling asleep or staying asleep. The donor should call right away if he or she is unable to arrive for this visit before 5 p.m. The team may have to cancel the donation. Step three is the white blood cell donation. This step includes preparing the night before and the morning of the donation. Donors will need to follow these instructions the night before the donation to help with the process. Start medicines as instructed. Drink plenty of water and stay hydrated. For best results, start hydrating 24 to 48 hours before donation. Eat full meals. Do not skip meals. Get a good night's rest. On the morning of the donation, donors should not binge or drink too much water. Once a donor is on the apheresis machine, the team cannot stop the procedure to allow the donor to go to the bathroom because the donation will have to be canceled. Donors should also limit their intake of beverages with caffeine because it can irritate the bladder. The white blood cell donation will take place at our blood donor center at the Holly Hall location. The donor will sit in a recliner chair with their feet up. The procedure will be similar to the pre-screen donation, except we will use both arms for the white blood cell donation. Blood is drawn from a vein in one arm and passed through a sterile blood separator machine. While the blood is in the separator, it is spun around and separated into the different blood components: red blood cells, white blood cells, platelets, and plasma. The white blood cells are carefully removed, and the rest of the donor's blood is returned to the donor in their other arm. When the donation procedure is complete, we will remove the needles from the donor's arms, help them slowly stand up, and walk the donor to the restroom. The donor may have some minor arm pain and should not do any heavy lifting for the rest of the day. The care team will review any physical activity restrictions the donors might have after the donation. Donors may contact the Blood Donor Operations Team at 713-792-7777 for any questions or concerns about the white blood cell donation process. The team is available to take your calls Monday through Sunday from 10 a.m. until 5 p.m. Patients should talk with their oncologist for any questions about the white blood cell transfusion process. Visit the Blood Bank webpage for more information.